You see?
I'm sorry. What are you doing? I have to be on the air in exactly 45 minutes.
Just give me half of that.
I'm Gary Belson with The Morning Show, and our resident bride-to-be, Lucy Wallace, is on her way in here with the news. Hey, apparently there's a late-breaking crisis in China. Yeah, Lucy's torn between Lenox and Wedgwood. What's the word, Luce? America needs to know.
Gary, when are you gonna get your own life and stop obsessing about mine?
Let me check my schedule. Tuesday.
Can I do the news now?
Oh, the comedy stylings of Lucy Wallace, ladies and gents. It's like, you like the Connie Chung of morning comedy. Do you sense that? Yeah, you know what? Go, do the news. They all turn off their radios during the news anyway. You know, I'm just gonna be here reading my fan mail.
I'm Lucy Wallace, WTMX News. But first, we just got word of a big accident, multiple fatalities, southbound Lakeshore Drive at Grand, 5 cars involved. We will stay on that for you. Mix 101.9. Hold on. Hey, Luce? Telephone 9-1. It's Officer Somebody.
Officer Somebody?
Hello.
Yes, it is.
Hey, the best I got this morning. You don't like that? You can. Hey, you know how the Pogues got their name? It means kiss my ass in Gaelic, so why don't you poke on out of here?
Hold on a second. Luce?
Ryan.
So take the photographs and still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life.
See, as I've got to have a change of scene, every night I have the strangest dream. Imprisoned by the way things used to be. Left here on my own, so it seems. Gotta get down before I start.
There. Alright.
This is really weird. I mean, we've hardly spoken lately.
But just be there for her, okay? Time will eventually help heal this wound. Hey, how you doing? This hurt. Sorrow's good. Sorrow's good.
Alex. I'm so sorry, Lucy. Oh my God, Alex, you're. Breast.
I know. They're eclipsed by my stomach. It's a cruel joke.
No kidding. My deepest sympathies, Lucy.
Lucy. Oh, Lucy, I'm so sorry.
Maya.
Jeez, Maya, it's a funeral, not a mod squad reunion.
Hey,
am so glad you guys are here. God, he looks great. I wonder what that is.
It's not a wife. He couldn't be married. We would have heard the collective wail of bimbos from one end of the city to the next.
So you went to college with her?
Yeah. We lived together after the dorms. Five of us. Lucy, Alex, Maya, and another guy, James.
And which one should I be jealous of?
All of them.
You slept with all of them?
Lucy, I am so sorry. This is Melissa.
Hi.
Oh, shit, stop.
I guess this is it.
That's Gary Belson.
He truly loved you. No, that's no good.
God, he sounds so much taller on the radio. Excuse me.
So how long have you been seeing Melissa?
This is our first date.
You bring a date to a funeral?
Derek never could go anywhere without something attached to his own life.
So, Derek, where is James? I haven't seen him in, like, ages.
No one knows. Lucy couldn't even get an address on him for the wedding.
Wow.
I always figured one of us would know where all of us were, you know?
Mm. Hey, little buddy.
She's too young for you, McCaffrey.
Say the unsayable. Do the impossible. To bid this unbearable goodbye to Ryan. And to share our grief with Ryan's fiancée, Lucy, who had hoped to share her dreams with Ryan, and have children with Ryan, and grow old with Ryan.
I think I should tell her.
No, I'm not getting pulled into this.
I mean, he or she thinks she's lost this perfect love, and it's a lie. On the other hand, her grief is so beautiful, so pure. Why dirty?
Exactly. Why dirty the grief?
I mean, and it's not like she can confront him. On the other hand, maybe she would get over him faster if I told her.
I give up.
You're right.
You know, he always had this ability to make fun wherever he went, no matter who he was with.
Every night since the day he passed, Simon visits me in my dreams. Sometimes I make a pot of tea.
You make tea in the dream?
Or maybe we don't feel like tea, so we go for a little walk.
Now, I know what you're talking. Now, listen, don't give me the look. I don't want the look.
I'm going to ask Maya and Derek. They'll know whether I should tell her.
Oh, as opposed to me, your husband, who has no clue.
I didn't mean it like that.
You know, I sometimes feel like a total outsider when you're all together.
No, we're not all together. James isn't
here. I mean, it's like I didn't live in that house, so I don't count.
Honey, that's not true.
Hey, do you think if I went to Northwestern that I would have lived in that house with the five of you?
I don't know.
I used to be a nice guy.
Tell me you are not hitting on me again.
I'm not hitting. What do you know?
He still worries a lot about the business. He always did.
I know.
James Bennett III.
Derek McCaffrey. The first.
me out of here.
When the road gets dark and you can no longer see, just let my love throw a spark and have a little faith in me.
I keep thinking that I'm gonna go home tonight and he's gonna be there. You know, telling me what a great job I did getting through it all today. You know? Listen to me, I sound like such an idiot.
No, no, don't worry about what you're supposed to be feeling right now, Liz. Okay? You get to win this one.
James, what do you think happens to us when we die?
Well, I like the idea that we come back. You know? Again and again in the same relationships. Until we get them right.
I will catch you. I will catch you. Oh, baby. Just have a little faith in me.
Can you say something to me in your radio voice?
I told you, this is my radio voice. That's why I use it on the radio.
Please, I just want to see if I can recognize it in person. Go ahead.
And I'll be back right after this.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm Jeffrey. I worked with Ryan.
You seem very happy considering this is his funeral.
So it's a funeral. But what if it's the great story we're supposed to tell our grandchildren?
So, all we heard was that you just dropped out of Harvard Law School.
Yes, I did.
God, your parents must have completely freaked out.
Oh, yeah. They had a few more martinis at the club that black day. I go to Yale now.
What?
Divinity School.
Well, I guess that makes sense.
Does it?
Your connections in life and you want to work for God. It makes you a little weird, you know that?
Oh, yeah, I felt that. I'm so proud of you.
Derek, tell us about Melissa.
Look, I know you two have been dying to give me a hard time over her. Just do it. Get it over with, please.
No. Not ready yet.
We're shaving up.
Excuse me.
Yeah. Hello, Dr. Hober.
Yeah, I'll be right there. Got a delivery. Can you get right home? All right. See you guys later.
You know, I hope you'll feign a little awe when I give birth.
I'll see you.
Everything okay between you two?
Oh, yes. He's just mad because I said that I didn't know if he could live in our Northwestern house.
He didn't go to Northwestern.
I know. It was hypothetical.
So why didn't you just tell him he could live in the hypothetical house?
Because the house wasn't hypothetical. The house was three of the best years of our lives.
I'm just really, you know, sorry.
Excuse me, Lucy. I'm Donna. Hello. I miss him so much.
I know. And I understand you have every reason to hate me.
What?
Oh, God. You didn't know.
No, wait a second. Who the hell are you?
Ryan told me that you knew.
Knew what?
He really did love you. You should know that.
No, don't you walk away from me. Get back here!
Now that your picture's in the paper, be perfectly admired.
Down, girl, you're not his type.
Why? What's his type?
Nuns.
Hey, listen, man, when these guys report, it's gonna be a blowout quarter. Oh, come on, baby, just pull the trigger. What do you say?
All right, I'll get back to you. Augie there. Hey, listen, man, it's McCaffrey. I need to buy 1 million shares of TRM at the market. T is in Tom, R is in Ralph, and M is in money in my pocket. All right, you too, man, I'll check you later. Hey, Bennett, I just made 12,000 bucks right before your eyes.
Congratulations. You think Lucy's awake yet?
It's weird, man. I have worked so hard to get a tiny piece of what you grew up with, and you just thumb your nose at it, don't you? I guess that's the difference between us. You can afford to thumb your nose at it.
Does it make you happy having money?
Yeah. Yeah, as a matter of fact, it does.
Then I envy you.
I just wish you were a little impressed. That's all.
I'm a little impressed. Luce, it's James. Pick up. Are you there?
This feeling that Alex knew about Ryan and this Donna thing, and I can't help but feel like if I had only known that maybe I could have done something. If I just had some sort of...
Water, like... It's
I'm sorry, I didn't know that you had company.
No, I'm sorry. I didn't get a chance to tell you yesterday. I'm Jeffrey. I worked with Ryan. He's a really great guy.
Nice. I'm really glad that you could get something out of this.
See, it wasn't like that.
A funeral shouldn't be a total waste of time.
Well, now, wait a minute. I'm not sure why I should be defending myself.
Yes, well, welcome to my world, because I'm not sure about anything. I don't even know who Ryan was. I do, however, know I have about 60 wedding gifts I have to return, so if you'll excuse me.
Lucy, just wait a minute. Wait.
You know what? I don't want to.
Keep a fire burning in your eyes. Pay attention to the open sky. You never know what will be coming down. I don't remember losing track of you. You're always dancing in and out of view. I must have thought you'd always be around. Always keeping things real by playing the clown. Now you're nowhere to be found. I don't know what happened. Can't seem to grasp it as hard as I try. It's like a song I can hear playing right in my ear. I can't sing, I can't help listening. And I can't help feeling stupid standing around. Crying is the easier down. Cause I know that you'd rather we were dancing.
We're making dinner.
Yes, cappuccino and a light porcini, mushroom sauce,
pizza. Your favorite merlot in Cabernet.
Very, very nice.
More.
You
want a little more? There you go.
This is really great sauce.
Thank you.
So you gonna stay here, Luz?
I don't know. I waited a year to get into this building. Maybe I'll have to get a roommate.
Oh, it looks so good.
Hey, whatever happened to all that stuff in the old house?
I've got most of it.
You do?
Yeah.
You have the big green chair?
Yeah. Why? Did you want it?
No. But I'd hate to think of it like, you know, with a bad family.
Aren't we sentimental fools? You remember that stuff? That stuff was such crap.
Sentimental? Sentimental nothing. I'm a struggling artist, Dare. I don't make six figures a year, you know? I'm really lucky if I make one.
You know, I think it's great what you're doing, Maya. You know what makes you happy and you're going after it?
Well, aren't you, James?
Honestly, I don't know.
Why the hell shouldn't you be happy, Bennett?
Derek.
No, I'm seriously sick of this lost soul crap from him. I think it's a damn luxury and a farce. I mean, just snap out of it, Bennett.
Yeah, you don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, I don't know you. That's for sure. And you look down at me.
There. Now one of you guys can just drop dead and you won't have any unresolved crap left hanging. I'm sorry.
It's okay.
No, it isn't. I just, how did I not know that things were such a mess between Ryan and me? I mean, how did he keep a straight face while we were planning our wedding, planning our life together? I mean, what was he thinking?
I'm sorry. I am so sorry. I wanted to tell you so many times, but I wasn't sure. And then things just seem so different between you and me lately, and I guess I hope that you weren't getting that serious with him, and then you did.
What? You're saying that it goes back that far?
Wow.
I guess that's why you've been avoiding me for the past year.
No, wait a minute, me avoiding you? You have acted like I've had the married and pregnant plague or something.
Yeah, well, they're all you ever talk about.
Well, that is my life. What do you expect me to talk about?
Why are you guys even here, really? I mean, none of us are even that close anymore. I mean, yeah, okay, once in a while, Maya, you and I will have lunch or something, and Derek, you know, we don't even call each other. And James. I mean, we don't even know where you are half the time. But here we are, having this dinner and acting like we're just best pals. What do you want to bet that as soon as the dust settles, I don't even see any of you again?
What was that?
My water. Just broke.
No! Oh, Seth is gonna be here any minute, okay?
Oh my God, here comes another one.
Okay.
Oh my God. Oh, you need a mint.
I do.
I'm sorry.
What masochist came up with this breathing crap?
Okay, but it's almost over, Alex.
Go ask them to check me again.
Okay, but I just...
Just go!
Okay.
Don't leave me!
I'm sorry.
What did they say?
I didn't get any... You know, I didn't get to ask.
God, this isn't fair. Huh? How am I supposed to be mad at you right now?
Here comes another one.
Okay, what can I do?
Okay, the focal point pictures.
Your what?
The pictures in my bag for me to focus on. My cat.
Okay. Okay, got it.
In front of my face.
Oh. Okay. Leave me a baby while I was staring at a stupid cat. I don't know.
I really miss you.
I miss you too.
Alex, I'm here.
Thank
it's okay.
God, the breathing. It's not working. Or the cat.
The cat.
He doesn't know about the cat.
You ready to have a baby, honey?
Hello, duh.
Paddington is never gonna get out of this one.
Not a substance that exists in nature. I go in search of fruit. Do you guys want anything?
Wonder what's playing tonight. 3D.
You know, I'm more than just a little impressed.
What?
With what you're doing.
I've been coming down kind of hard on
you. No, I probably deserved it.
Let's watch some TV.
I love Lucy.
Fine, what channel?
No, Our Lucy. I love her. Always have. And she doesn't love me. Not like that.
Well, that explains a lot.
Thought I might.
I saw her head.
Okay, Alex, you're doing great. I want you to rest out a couple of contractions, okay?
Wait, are you sure, man? I think she's got a lot of momentum right now. I mean, why not finish it off?
I'm just trying to avoid a laceration.
You know, I don't know. You know, I'm not nuts about the baby's heart rate.
I don't know what you're talking about. The baby is fine.
Look, all I'm saying is I saw a short D-cell on the monitor.
Here comes another one. What's the verdict?
Pushed. That was during a contraction.
Is the pediatrician on his way up here?
Can you just calm down 1 minute, Seth, please?
Okay, you know what? Calm down, it's your kid.
I love you.
I love you too.
Please leave the room.
Yes.
Okay, here we go. Say hi to your daughter. Hold her head. She's all yours.
You made that?
She's so beautiful.
We're your parents.
Yeah.
Yes, hello.
Okay, we should leave him alone. Who is that girl senior year who kept us up all night?
Oh, yes. The whimperer.
What a whimper.
Oh, come on. Please. You know what we're talking about. It was like having a pet wolf in the house.
Yeah, even higher. It was strange, like alien thing.
Derek. I have no idea what you're talking about.
Oh, please, yeah.
Oh.
Sam, you're not gonna take off too soon, are you?
No, I think I'm gonna stick around for a while.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I know a place you can stay.
Oh, yeah? Great, great.
Now, Lucy's. She needs a roommate.
No, I'll find a place.
Oh, no. No, you are gonna stay with me.
No, I'm gonna.
It's perfect. Oh, no,
come on,
you
come
don't!
Here.
It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life.